Hey guys, welcome to our weekly video devotional. I'm glad to be with you guys this week. I hope everyone is having a good summer, and I cannot wait to be with all of you again come August. So this week we are going to talk briefly about God's continuing work in your heart and your fight for your life. So we're going to start in Philippians 1 verse 6. And I am certain that God, who began the good work within you, will continue his work until it is finally finished on the day when Christ Jesus returns. When you accept Jesus, when you begin following him, when you make him your Lord, God begins a work in you. He begins to make you like him. And this work that he begins in you, he is going to finish. He's not going to leave it half done. And so so this past week, I got pretty upset. Luca did something that kind of ticked me off, and I was probably more stern with him. I yelled a little bit, I think, and I immediately felt bad for maybe going a little too far. I wish I could go back and change the way that I responded to Luca, have maybe calmed down a little bit before I disciplined him. I felt like, sometimes I feel like as a Christian, I should be perfect, right? Jesus even says, be perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect. And there are times that I do mess up and I do things that I get too mad at someone or I just do something I shouldn't. I say something that I shouldn't say. And I feel grief. Right? The Bible says that godly grief leads to repentance. And that's important. Repentance is an important part of that. But this good work that God has started in you, he will finish. And I took heart to that this week because I was feeling like, God, I wish I had more control over my anger sometimes. And God reminded me that he is going to finish this good work, that it's not over, that he's not done with me because of it, but he plans on finishing the good work that he started in me. And this is called sanctification. It's a big Christianese word that just means that God is making you to be more like him. The Bible says that the old you has died and that the new you has risen and that God has given you new life. And I think this is something both that God does in you, but also something you have to fight for. J.C. Ryle, an old dead guy, has a quote that says, "In justification, the word to be addressed is to man is believe, only believe. In sanctification, the word must be watch, pray, and fight. Watch, pray, and fight." So I think there are three parts of this. We need to watch. We need to be aware of what's happening, of how we are treating people, of what we're doing. We need to pray. God has to be a part of this. We can't do it on our own, right? If we were doing it on our own, we would just be like the world. It would just be another self-help program. It wouldn't be God's work in us. And then lastly is fight. And that fight is important. God does not let you sit back and just passively receive, right? God wants to know that you're in this to win and that you are willing to put forth the effort and willing to commit to living holy. God's not going to do all of it for you. He's not going to overnight make you perfect. It's something you're going to have to fight for. God began a good work in you, and he's going to finish it, but it's something that you are co-laborers with Christ towards. Let's continue in Philippians 1, verse 9. I pray that your love will overflow more and more, that you will keep on growing in knowledge and understanding. For I want you to understand what really matters, so that you may live pure and blameless lives until the day of Christ's return. May you always be filled with the fruit of your salvation, the righteous character produced in your life by Jesus Christ. For this will bring much glory to God, much glory and praise to God. I love this. I love this section of scripture. It's something that you have to grow in, right? Paul says, you will keep on growing in knowledge and understanding. Part of the Christian life is growing in Jesus. Jesus wants us to be pure and blameless when he returns. And part of that is this sanctifying work that God is doing in us. And he says this, may you always be filled with the fruit of your salvation. Your salvation isn't just a ticket to heaven, right? There's fruit of it. And that fruit, he says in the next section, is the righteous character produced by God, by Jesus in your life. The righteous character produced in your life by Jesus Christ. Righteous character is an important thing. It's not something to be put off. It's not something to, one day I'll be righteous. No. It should be a fruit of your salvation. Righteous character should be a fruit of your salvation. So, God is perfecting you. He's perfecting you. And he's making you more like him. And this sanctifying work is not easy. It's not something that is going to come right away. There may be times that God delivers you of some intense sin, and that is amazing, right? And praise God for it. But he doesn't always do that, and it's not a rule. It's something you have to fight for. It's something that that you have to, in some ways, work for. Now, I'm not saying that you have to work for your salvation. That is a gift of God. But your sanctification is a co-labor. It's something that you work on with Christ. Jesus is working in your heart, and you have to take those steps to get there. And praise God for it, right? God is trying to train you to be the bride of Christ. And Paul Bilheimer's book, Destined for the Throne, talks all about that. It's a beautiful book. I recommend you pick it up. Remember this week that God is still working in you, that he's not done. He's not going to leave this project half finished, but he's going to make you like him. Thanks for watching, and I can't wait to see you guys again in a few weeks. Yeah. Have a good rest of your summer. Bye.